testing out some new products. So, hey y'all, I'm Tiffany SM. If you're new to my channel, welcome. And if you're not new, welcome back. So I'm sure you've noticed by now, but I am completely barefaced, and that is because I'm going to do a get ready with me, and I'm going to be testing out a lot of new products. So I'm really excited to do this. It's not a full face of first impressions, but it's kind of like a get ready with me and testing out some new products, kind of like a two-in-one. So yeah, I thought it would be fun to try these products out with you guys, and yeah, that's pretty much it. So if you would like to see this video, then please just keep watching. So I just ran out of my brow pencil, and my holy grail is the L'Oreal Brow Stylist Definer. That's my favorite pencil. I love that pencil, and I just ran out of it yesterday. Went out to grab a new one, and I thought, you know what, since I'm going to be filming this video, let me try something new. So I picked up a different one, and I'm nervous because I'm nervous. But this is the Revlon Colorstay Brow Pencil in the shade Soft Black. There is what it looks like, and it has a spoolie on the end. So let's put this to the test and see how it works. Okay, so first I'm just going to take the spoolie, as always, and just brush my hairs into place in the shape that I want them to go in. Here we go. Has a nice formula. The shape is a little bit different than what I'm used to. It's angled, but and that's kind of why I got it, because I really like the Anastasia Brow Definer, and it has an angled tip, but this is not the same as that. It's different, but not necessarily bad. It's just different.
Okay, so I went ahead and finished my brows, and then I just set them with my favorite brow gel, the L'Oreal Brow Stylist Plumper, and then I went in and carved them with this shade right here. And this is just a concealer palette that I got off of Amazon, and I really like it for carving out my brows and using as
but
an eyeshadow.
Anyway,
base.
Yes, on this pencil, I didn't use a powder. Normally I'll go in with a powder, but I didn't do that with this pencil because I wanted to see how it performed without one, and I like this, I think. I mean, I do like it, but you know, sometimes you have to use stuff a little bit more to know if you really like something. But my first impression of this, I really like it. I like the color a lot. Alrighty, so next I'm gonna go in and prime my eyelids, and I will be using the Urban Decay Anti-Aging Primer. Sorry. Kind of has the same shade as the other one, but I can tell you right off the gate, this one is a lot more moisturizing than the original. I really like this one. If you're somebody that has dry eyelids, try that one, the Urban Decay Anti-Aging. I really, really
like
it.
So for eyeshadow today, I feel like I'm gonna get hate from somebody somewhere for using this, but I'm gonna be working with the Kylie Cosmetics Royal Peach Palette.
And I don't know, you guys, I know there was a lot of controversy surrounding this palette because of the smell and all that jazz, but I'm weak, okay? I'm weak. And this palette, it just spoke to me, and I think the shades in it are beautiful. And what really drew me to this palette is the fact that I can use every single shade. And there's so many palettes with my skin tone, I can't say that for. But every shade in this palette I can use, and that's really what drew me to it. So I hope the quality is good. We're about to find out. But I think the palette itself is stunning. I mean, the colors are beautiful. Now, like I said, there was a lot of controversy surrounding this palette because of the smell. I don't smell anything. I did buy this on the second release. I didn't get it on the first. And I kind of wonder if maybe they tried to fix that with the second batch. But I don't smell anything. Okay, I'll take that back. Take it back. You can definitely smell a chemically smell, like if you're that... I just stuck my nose in there. If you're like this.
And what I'm guessing is it's the pans from where the pans, you know, they glue the pans to the palette. That's what I think it is. But just, you know, like here, opening it, I don't smell anything. So, you know, it doesn't bother me because I will never have that palette this close to my nose anyway. But just opening it to work with, no, I don't smell anything. So let's put these shadows to the test. And the first thing I'm going to do is go in and set that primer down with this shade right here, which I think is called Crush. I don't like how she puts the names. Like, let me show you. She puts the names on the back of the palette. I don't like that because it's confusing for me. And I don't know if I'm telling y'all right or not. But I think, yeah, I think this is called Crush. So I'm going to go in and just set that primer down with this. Does have a nice big mirror on it, which I do appreciate. So yeah, basically all I'm doing with this shade is just setting that primer down, and this will make all the other shades blend out easier. So next I'm going to go in with this really pretty peachy tone right here, and I think this is called Peachy. Yeah, this shade right here, and it's called Peachy, and I'm going to put that above my crease. Since my eye shape is on the smaller side when I'm working with my crease, my transition color, I like to actually go above my crease and then put a crease color, you know, in the actual crease. And I think that kind of helps create the illusion of my eyes being a little bit bigger than what they actually are. That shade is really pretty. I don't know if you guys can see, but it's really pretty and it's nice and pigmented. So I'm going to just kind of go in and add a little bit more. That's beautiful. That's really pretty shade. Well, the pigmentation on these mattes is really nice so far. I'm impressed so far. Okay, so next I'm just going to take a clean blender brush, and this is a brush set that I got off of Amazon, so I don't know if it's any good or not, but my other blending brushes are dirty, but it's clean, it has no product in it, and I'm just going to kind of blend that out and make it softer, because I'm going for a soft peachy look, so don't want any harsh lines. But you guys, I cannot even lie, so far I really like this palette. I can't say I like the palette after just using one shadow, but this shade that I just started out with is really beautiful, and it's nice and pigmented, and I'm really shocked that it showed up on my skin tone as easy as it did. That's always something I look for. So I must say, so far I'm impressed. So next I'm going to go in with this shade right here, and this shade is called Cinnamon, and I'm going to pop that directly into the crease. So I have a question, like, for those of you out there who have school-aged children. You know, do you ever consider yourself to be, like, a, you know, semi-intelligent person? Because I like to consider myself a semi-intelligent person. I mean, I think I'm pretty smart. But, you know, do you ever have that thought and then your kid comes home from school and they want you to help them with their homework? And then you realize, I don't know, maybe you're not as smart as you thought you were. Or is it just me? Because I'm telling you what, my kids, and my oldest two, are in the 4th and 6th grade. And you guys, honestly, they will bring home stuff that I have no freaking clue how to do. And to be honest with you, it's embarrassing. You know? It's embarrassing. Because I feel like a lot of times your kids, like, they put you on this pedestal and they forget that you're just human too, and you do the best you can. But it's a humbling experience to just kind of admit to your child that you have no idea how to do their homework. Just saying. Alright, so I have my crease pretty much how I want it, and you guys, I have to say, like, that, what was it called, cinnamon color took a little bit more building, but overall, I'm really impressed with the quality of her matte shadows. Just the fact that they show up this well on my skin tone tells me a lot. And that's just my honest opinion. So please don't get mad at me for saying that I like them, but you know, I do. And I spend a lot of time building up eyeshadows. I mean, it's ridiculous how hard I have to work to make some of them show up on my skin tone, but this was pretty much effortless. And I appreciate that. So moving on, I'm going to move on to my lid color. And I think I'm going to use this color right here. And this is called Duchess. And yeah, I'm just going to pop that on my lid. And I think I'm actually just going to use my finger. There's what the pigment looks like on my finger. Not the butteriest formula in the world, but it's all about what it looks like. I've heard that her shimmery shadows in this palette were not the best. So yeah, that's another reason why I'm using my finger. But I like to just use my finger a lot of times to apply shimmers anyway. But it's not that bad. I've definitely used shimmers that are better than this, but they're not the worst that I've used. I will say though, I do like the matte shadows better than the shimmers, although I don't know if that's really fair to say since I've only tried this one. But just based off of this one, I like the matte formula better than the shimmer. But the color is pretty. I don't know how well you can see it, but I really like it with the crease colors. It's pretty. I don't know you guys, but I'm kind of digging this palette if I'm being completely honest. Okay, so next, I think I'm going to pop some of this on the lid, and these are the Revlon, what are they called? PhotoReady Eye Arts, and you have a cream shadow on one end, and then you have glitter on the other end. And I'm just kind of going to do a light layer of it, because I like my glitter to kind of be more subtle and not super heavy. Looks pretty. So I'm gonna do the other eye and let it dry, and I'll be right back. Alright you guys, I'm back and I have let this dry, and my thoughts on this, I love this. This is stunning. I don't know if you can tell, and I did have a little bit of transfer on this eye because I was talking and moving my face and it transferred before I let it dry, but we're just gonna overlook that. But the product itself, this is beautiful, and it was really easy to use. So to finish up the eyes, at least this part of the eyes, I'm gonna go in with this shade right here, and I think this is Sorbet, and just highlight my brow bone. Yeah, you guys, I really like this palette so far. All right, you guys, now I'm going to move on to the face. And first, I am going to prime, and I'm going to go in with my favorite pore filling primer, which is the Benefit Professional, and just fill in those pores. I take about that much. It doesn't take that much at all. And first, I just kind of tap it into my problem areas, which is right here in my T-zone. And then I take the excess and kind of go like where I have lines under my eyes. And then I'll go back, and with very light pressure, just go in circular motions. And then I'll rotate and go the other way to make sure those pores are really filled in. And then I'll just kind of tap and make sure they're really filled in. And then just look at the difference from this side to this side. Boom. Boom. Really does make a difference. I love the Professional. So I'm going to just go over here and do the same thing. Okay, and then after I do that, I go in with a different primer. And today I'm going to be using my favorite primer at the moment. And this is the Becca First Light Priming Filter. I really love this primer. It has a purple tint to it, but once you put it on the face, it's not purple. But it just makes your skin, it's like it brings your skin to life. And it just makes it look so nice and healthy, but not like in an overpowering way. And I really, really love this primer because I have very dry skin. And it just makes it look so nice and radiant and healthy, which is what I like. I like for my foundation in my makeup to have more of a dewy finish, because I just think with my skin type, that's what looks better. But don't get me wrong, I will do a matte face if the occasion calls for it. But on a day-to-day basis, I just like it to be more radiant and dewy. And this primer is just, it's bomb, especially if you have dry skin. But I think someone with oily skin could use it because it's not overpowering. It just, it's like your skin just drank water. I love it. All right, it's time to move on to our face makeup, and I'm gonna be testing out this new sponge from Eco.
I'm also gonna be testing out this foundation as well, and this just came out a couple months ago,
and I've had it for a while and I have not touched it. But this is the Neutrogena Hydro Boost Hydrating Tint with hyaluronic acid. Moisturizes and plumps skin for 24 hours, which I don't know who would be wearing a foundation for 24 hours. And I'm in the shade Chestnut 135. So, yeah, I'm excited to try this. I love the Neutrogena Healthy Skin. Oh, okay. Anyway, I love the Neutrogena Healthy Skin. That's one of my favorite. Oh, okay. That's one of my favorite foundations from the drugstore, is the Neutrogena Healthy Skin. I think it's totally underrated because I never hear anybody talk about it, but I love that foundation. So I'm really excited to try this. This reminds me a lot of the Clinique Beyond Perfecting, whatever it's called. But anyway, let's see what this bad boy is about. And I'm just going to dot it all over the skin. Alright, here we go. I hope this shade matches. It looked like it will be a good match. That's another reason I was drawn to it, because the shade itself looks The shade itself looked like such a beautiful shade, and it didn't have a ton of red or orange in it, and I was just really drawn to the shade. Before I go in with my concealer, I am going to do a little bit of correcting, and I'm just going to go in with my Becca Under Eye Brightening Corrector, just a little bit, and correct. I like to just kind of do three dots and use my finger to blend it out, because I find it works best that way. And I also find with this, the less amount you use, the better. But I do really like this corrector. I think it does help brighten. And it just works. I highly recommend this. I like it a lot. So, okay. Since this foundation is really light coverage, I'm just going to use my Maybelline Fit Me concealer, which is one of my favorite concealers. I love it. And I'm just going to use not much. Here lately, I've been using a lot less concealer than I used to. I don't know, I'm gonna just highlight the center, the whole center of my face with this. I just have been liking it better. I don't know, I've been going like kind of for the whole minimalist thing here lately. And I can't lie, I've kind of been digging it. It's just easier, you know. And plus, once it spring and summer hits, I don't like to go all heavy with the makeup.
Just like to keep it simple.
I'm blending this out. I'm bringing it down a little bit. And that's another thing I found. I used to do like the whole triangle thing and bring concealer all the way down here and just have like a ton on. But I just really here lately have been feeling like it's not necessary. You can drag the product down there and still get the same effect. So yeah, I love this brush, you guys. You see how quick that was to blend that out? Excuse the ugly concealer face that I'm...
Excuse me. My camera cut off on me because my battery was dead. Charged it up a little bit, and I'm out of memory. I had no space, so I had to stop and delete stuff. But anyway, back to the video. When my camera died, I did go ahead and set my face with the Laura Mercier Translucent Loose Setting Powder in the shade Medium Deep. This is not new. This was sent to me by Influencer to test and review, and honestly, I'm obsessed. I love this powder so much, and I can see why it's so popular in the beauty community. But yes, the camera cut out, but I did set my whole face with this powder. So next, what am I doing next? Let's finish the eyes, and let's go and do my lower lash line. Okay, so in my waterline, I just went in with Colourpop's pencil liner, their Creme gel liner in the shade Honeydude, and it's just a nude, and this is probably my favorite shade. I'm gonna go in with this peachy shade right here, and then just take it along my lower lash. Connected it to the outside, and then next I'm gonna go in with this cinnamon shade and then just put it on the outer corner and just kind of connect it to what's up here so it all kind of ties together. My camera went out on me again, so I went ahead and popped on my mascara, and next I'm going to go in with a bronzer, and this is the e.l.f. highlighter bronzer duo. I don't know the technical name for it, in the shade Turks and Caicos. I got this for free. A lot of times e.l.f. will, if you order $25 worth of stuff, they'll send you stuff for free, and I got this for free, so I'm not sure how it's going to work, but I don't really want to do, ooh, oh my gosh, you guys, that's pretty. I don't want to contour since I'm going for a softer look. Oh my gosh, you guys. It is so hard to find a bronzer that's an actual bronzer for my skin tone. But this definitely bronzes up my skin. Loving that. Alright, so moving on, let's move to some blush. And I do have a new blush to try out. And this is one of Milani's newer blushes in the shade Belly? Bella Bellini, and it's like a peachy pink with some gold in it. I think this could be used as a highlighter too. Oh boy. Yeah, I think that would work better for me. Oh my god, as a highlighter. Beautiful though, I just don't know if it's gonna work for me as a blush. So I'm gonna grab a different brush and I'll be right back. Okay, so I'm just taking my Real Techniques blush brush and really trying to blend. I had no idea that would go on like that. That was kind of a fail. But I do think it would be a pretty highlight for my skin tone. But the color itself is stunning. I'm going to swatch it for you real quick just because you probably didn't get the best idea off of my application. But there it is on my finger. Beautiful, and there it is swatched on the back of my hand. Yeah, that's definitely a highlight for me. It is so pretty though. So pretty. Okay, so for highlight, I'm gonna go in with this new highlighting palette by Zoeva. It's called the Summer Stroke Spectrum Palette, and there is the packaging, which is absolutely stunning. It feels like NARS packaging. I love it. With the rose gold writing on it, and here is what the inside looks like. So pretty. Okay, and I'm gonna use this shade right here, which is like a peachy pink
because I think that would go the best with this look.
Ooh. Okay.
I wasn't expecting it to be that pigmented off of just one swipe. Holy crap. And next, I'm going to highlight the inner corner of my eyes, and I'm going to take this new highlighter I have from Ammo Cosmetics in the shade Instinct. And it's like a peachy pink. And there, oh my gosh, there it is, swatched. Haven't tried the, somebody wins and some lose. I can see through your disguise. Lay it down, hope for something better. Looking at the clouds, the silver and the weather. You can't keep this up. Okay. So I wet my brush with some Fix Plux, and we're going to Fix Plux? Plus, and we're gonna see if that will help intensify this shade. Oh yes, there we go. Yeah. Y'all, I'm about ready to take this camera and throw it out the dadgum window. Oh my gosh, it keeps going out on me, and it is the most frustrating thing. Oh my gosh. Okay. So I think when my camera went out, I was putting that highlighter on the inner corners of my eyes, and I think it's really pretty. Just added a nice effect. And doing that, I feel like makes my eyes look a little bit bigger. But yeah, that's the last thing I was doing. So now we just have lips, and then we will be done. And I am going in with the Bite Beauty Matte Lip Crayon, I think, in the shade Pastel. Not sure if I'm pronouncing that right, but here is what the shade looks like. It's really pretty. I just thought a lip like this would look nice with this look. So let's give it. Brown lip liner, but I really, really, really like the formula. Feels really nice on the lips. But yeah. And then I'm going to go over top of it with this Too Faced Sweet Peach Creamy Peach Oil Lip Gloss in the shade Dab on Peach. A little bit on,
and then just kind of.
That smells really good.
Ooh. Smells really good. Oh my gosh. And it feels really good on the lips. Ooh, I like this. Okay, so I'm not sure how I feel about the color of the lipstick, but I really do like the formula of the Bite Beauty Lip Crayon. It's really nice, and I really love that Too Faced lip oil. It feels really good on the lips. Okay, and I said those were last, but we can't forget our setting spray. And for this, I'm going to be using the Urban Decay Chill. I do have the original, the all-nighter. Could I sound more country? I have the all-nighter, and I like that one. But I do, I mean, it's a little bit drying, but it's like hairspray for your face. So. Does have a chilling feeling to it. I'm obsessed with setting sprays, facial mist, all that stuff. So as far as how it goes with keeping your makeup on, obviously I don't know that yet, but I will update the description box and let you know how everything wore if you're interested. And also, I will put all the products I always do in the order that I talk about them in the description box and where you can find them. I've never told you guys that, but I do that, so yeah, I'm telling you, I always do that, but everything will be in the description box, and yeah,
this is the final look. I mean, I could have at least done something to my hair and put a decent shirt on. This is the final look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. It was kind of just like a little informal hanging out with me while I test. So anyway, I'm going to give you a quick rundown of my thoughts on everything. So on the eyebrow pencil from Revlon. I didn't even feel the need to use a powder. I just filled my brows in with this. Like I said, the tip takes some getting used to. Wasn't crazy about the spoolie, but overall, I really like this pencil, and I really like Urban Decay Primer Potion. Just upon initial use, I really liked it. I like how hydrating it felt on my lids, but as far as knowing how it works as a primer and keeping the shadows in place, I really don't know yet because I haven't had it on long enough. But I do really like the way it felt on my lids. And I do feel like my shadows are vibrant. So, just a first impression on this.
This guy right here.
Have to be honest, guys. I love this palette. Just based off of the shades that I used, I really, really love it. The pigment is there for me. And I think these shades are perfect for women of color. I find them to be very flattering for my skin tone. And I appreciate that. So, my first impression of this, I love it. Can't wait to play with it a little bit more. The foundation or moisturizing tint, hydrating tint is what it's called. I like this a lot. Not a lot of coverage, but I think it will be really nice in the summer months. It's hydrating. Doesn't feel like there's anything on the skin whatsoever. So I like it. I actually like this a lot, and I think I will get a lot of use of this in the summer. The Revlon PhotoReady Eye Art. This I love. Love, love, love. I think it is so pretty, and it's easy. You know, pigments and lip glitters can be a pain to work with, but this was very easy to use. After that initial transfer it did, and that was my fault because I was talking and didn't let it dry, it has not transferred at all, and I did not even use a glitter glue with it. So I really, really like this. Can't wait to play with it some more
next,
in the other
shades.
The Milani blush. Like I said, Milani baked blushes are my absolute favorite from the drugstore. However, I don't think this shade is going to work for me as a blush. But I think it will make a beautiful highlight or even a blush topper. But as a blush on its own, on my skin tone, can't go wrong with Milani baked blushes. And this shade is stunning. The Eco Tool Sponge. I liked it. I did. And I forgot to mention, it comes with... Let me grab it real quick. I'm so sorry. Here it is. It comes with this one too. A smaller version that you can use probably is meant for under here. But I just use this one. But my first impression of this, I actually did like it.
This is right
here. I'm just going to go ahead and grab it. I'm completely out of order now. I apologize, but it is what it is. But the Ammo Cosmetics highlighter in Extinct, I think it is stunning. I did take some and mix it in with that other highlighter because I felt like it was a little bit too light. And I have it on the inner corners. I need to play with it some more and use it, you know, by itself to get a good idea. But my first impression of this is it's beautiful. It's a very unique color, and there's the swatch on the back of my hand. I'm excited to play
right
with
along.
I feel like I'm just all over the place. I'm usually so much more organized than this. I'm so sorry. Moving on to this guy, the Zoeva palette. First impression, I do think this shade right here is too light for me on its own. But I can mix it with the darker shades and probably make it work. But based off of what, you know, the pigmentation alone, it's a definite yes. I wasn't expecting that much pigment from this, so I'm really excited to play with this some more. The Bite Beauty Matte Lip Crayon, I like a lot. I'm not sure how I feel about this color, but I can make it work with a brown lip liner. But the formula, I really like. It's very comfortable.
And the Too Faced, oh, look at that. I just noticed that.
Cute, right? This... I love. Smells good. It feels really good. It doesn't, it's not like thick like a lip gloss. It's, I can't explain it, but this lip oil I really, really like.
Last but not least.
Excuse me for a moment, please. The Urban Decay All Nighter. No, this is not the All Nighter. This is the Chill Setting Spray. And I can't say how it is as a setting spray, but just the feeling of it. I like. It does give that cooling effect, and I like that. And I do feel like it made some of the powderness. The cakey look that you can get from powders, I feel like it did help take some of that away, and I like it. So overall, with the stuff I tested out, I'm pretty happy with it, to be honest. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up, and don't forget to click that subscribe button while you're at it if you would like to. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys next time, and until next time, take care. Peace and love.